Hi, my name is Brittany Gonzalez, your Bacon Bandit here from Brittany's Biscuits, and I'm here with episode 5 of my web series with a new year and a new hairstyle and a new location. Believe it or not, you can probably guess, I am in Harlem, and in my 7 years of living in New York City, I have never been to this wonderful historic neighborhood. So let's go out, learn some new stuff, and hopefully hand out some new cookies as well.
Welcome to Harlem.
Yep, it's my first time in Harlem.
Oh my goodness.
Been in New York 7 years, never been to Harlem.
Wow. Oh look! Oh my gosh.
You can tell, right?
Naturalistic cookies. I love it.
Black, I mean, I'm Trinidadian, but it's still the same
color. Hey, same, baby. That's why we all,
exactly.
Our mothers made
color.
Us this color so we can identify each other wherever we go.
Exactly, we're the same color.
Thank you so much. What a pleasure to visit.
Of course.
All the way around.
I absolutely adore stained glass windows. No, I did actually our project in 8th grade, and in one of it was painting with standard watercolors stained glass windows. And they say you can take any picture you want and just make it into a stained glass window. And I chose to do a picture of my cat. And I know it sounds silly, but I use bright colors, I use just the most bold paints, and she taught us how to do stained glass window paintings, and it was probably one of the best things I thought I ever painted. And ever since then, it's just been a thing for me. Pieces of colors just coming together to make something gorgeous, and that's why I love churches. So there's a little thing you guys may have heard of called a CP time. It is well known as a colored people time, which essentially means that in Harlem, Christmas is in March and will extend through to March instead of being through to January. This is obvious proof. So this is a phenomenon you guys are gonna have to get familiar with if you're gonna live in Harlem. Just saying. Let's move on. That's another thing I do like about Harlem, and don't tell Brooklyn I said this, but their murals are amazing. Like, it reminds me a lot of Philly murals. And that's another reason why I like New York City in general. Like, it reminds me a lot of Philly. It reminds me a lot of home. This is crazy. So we just walked around and we kind of found Alexander Hamilton's old crib. And for those of you who don't know me, I am a massive history buff. So we're just gonna go inside here and see what's up. And I feel as if I'm gonna learn a lot more than I actually plan on doing, which is also fun. So let's go.
He retired from the Federal Service, mm-hmm. and he buys 32 acres of land here, which is all Philippine United, 32 acres. There's all farmland. In the 1800s, he buys it, starts building the house. It's completed in 1802, mm-hmm. and he moves in with his wife and 8 kids. And he's killed in the duel in 1804, yeah. So he only has 2 years here. So, but this is his house.
Right. Still use the same type of key, skeleton key, to lock.
That's great. Yes, please.
To lock it and unlock it.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Hamilton got involved in an affair.
Mm-hmm. No,
but politicians don't do that anymore.
Surprise me.
With a woman from Philadelphia.
Oh God, we gotta get in everything. Oh my God.
Bad.
I like how he feels guilty about the affair in these portraits. Like he's looking at his wife, like,
yeah.
I swear to God, yeah. She meant nothing to me. I swear. And she's just having none of it.
Alexander, is it true?
Let me be Black History Month.
Mm.
Yeah,
cool.
It's chocolate. Just chocolate and royal icing.
I'll savor it. Hamilton was killed in the duel.
Yeah.
Okay. But what it doesn't mention is that a year before he was killed, his oldest son.
Uh-oh.
Good. His oldest son, yes, got killed in a duel.
Oh, wow.
Before, a year before they moved into the house. In the same place, mm-hmm. and over in Weehawken, New Jersey,
mm-hmm.
and with the same pistols that his father is going to be killed with.
That's
defending
crazy.
His father's honor.
Thank you so very much. You've been
You're
awesome.
Welcome.
And I'm definitely coming back.
These are the
best cookies I've ever had.
They're good.
Thank you so much. Bye.
I wish they'd stay warm, but
no. look at this, warm. God.
See, y'all making fun of my hair, but I can never be as good as this, man. Real talk. I mean, can you imagine? That's what you see in the next video. We'll do just like that. Right there. So I got my first souvenir from Harlem, the Gay North of East Years. And I won't delve into that history right now. You're going to have to look them up, but this does mean a bit to me. So if you look them up, you'll know why. I'm at the historic Cotton Club. It doesn't look like much, but like all things, appearances can be very deceptive. And I don't know, this is just... I should have known, but I had no idea Harlem was this deep-rooted in history. And I probably learned more about this neighborhood than in any neighborhood in the entire city. Did was I interviewed with these lovely gentlemen about the upcoming Image Awards and how African Americans are portrayed in the media. So I decided to help them out, give my little opinion. I mean, as a fellow film, you know, take what you want. They're chocolate and royal icing, don't worry. They have like African hearts.
Yeah,
absolutely. Chocolate, royal icing.
You made it yourself?
Uh-huh. Oh,
thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Can I ask you a question? I'll give you some free cookies, I promise. I made it myself.
Well, I'm on a diet, but I'll probably save it.
Well, what I wanted to ask is, I'm doing a little piece about Black History Month, and, you know, I'm a baker, so I've been going around, like, asking people different questions, so.
Sure.
I just wanted to know, like, if I imagine you celebrate, like, is there any particular thing that like, you learned this month that you didn't know before, or?
I just I know a lot more about Nelson Mandela.
Oh wow!
I'm sorry that it took his death in order for us as a public to get more documentaries and good programming regarding this wonderful leader. You know, I didn't take the time to find out more about this great man. And to be honest with you, I just learned a lot and. My kids are half black, half Spanish, so yeah. And so I took the time to let them know a side of society that they're not being told. You know, they're being told something in school, and then society says something else by its norms and rules. And so I try to tell them both sides of the story, the good and the bad about our people.
We start having like more walks to speak for our rights. To stand up for our rights. I mean, the system just passed by right now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Do you think there's any hope?
Well, the only hope that we have is if we start having walkouts.
Yeah.
Start having march. You know, we don't have nothing.
Yeah.
You know, they tell us what they want us to hear, and we accept it and we move on. It's not helping us.
I can definitely say something. Like, I just said something to my brother. Like, they're not even celebrating. Like, I don't hear too much about Black history no more. Like, for the kids, I don't know if it's because I'm not in school where they do that, but I'm not hearing. Like, my son hasn't brought anything back home about Black history or not. And I know it's not up to the schools, but still, that's where we were learning it and really getting a hands-on on Black history, and I don't see it, I don't hear it.
And they should talk about it because they need to explain like our heritage, like where we came from, like what was our struggle from getting from there to here.
What do you feel as if that could be done? Like, what do you have any suggestions? I'm not trying to say give me a bullet point plan, but is there anything that could be done?
We gotta do it ourselves.
If schools can't do it, do it yourself.
Yeah, so did you learn anything this Black History Month?
Yeah.
What did you learn, love?
I learned about how I learned a poem in school and I forgot it.
You forgot? Did you study anybody specific for Black History Month in school?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember who? Who is it?
Martin Luther King.
That's the best answer I'm ever going to get. All right, so my adventure ends here, and I learned a lot here. My first trip to Harlem, it certainly will not be my last. And I also learned a lot about Black History Month and how African Americans feel about it. And being one myself, I agree with them. I think we have a lot more work to do. I think if we stick together, we'll be all right. But we still got more progress to make. And if you want to hear more about my business and how I'm trying to make that progress, you can go online to my shop at etsy.com/shop/Brittany's Biscuits. You can check me out on Instagram at Brittany's Biscuits, on Twitter at Bite the Biscuits, Facebook at Brittany's Biscuits, and you can go on my YouTube channel where you can view my previous episode at www.brittanysbiscuits.com. Thank you for tuning in for episode 5. Welcome to 2014, and let's hopefully see you next month. Have a good one.